You have a lot of interesting things. I'll be back, and I'll bring some friends along. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Come, little ones. You should have a pillow for your chair. I'm sure there's one somewhere.
It would have been lonely without you, Tangy.
Mr. Winkle placed a tiny pillow on Tangy's chair.
Now it's your turn, Jack.
He then snipped off the old bells from Jack's hat and sewed on new ones. Jack trembled with joy. All at once, something happened that had never happened before.
Cuckoo! Cuckoo!
Oh. Oh, my goodness. Hello, little bird. It looks like we have another addition to our little family. Welcome, welcome.
It was very late when Mr. Winkle finally finished his chores, locked the door, and retired to his tiny apartment above the store.
Good night, little ones. Merry Christmas.
Do you believe this? We're a family! We've been home all along and we didn't know it.
Santa knew it? Ah, gee. He really does know everything. Do you realize how lucky we are? We met the real Santa.
I guess you're right.
Yes, Tangy, Jack, and Bird went on and on about meeting the real Santa. Virgil, their good and loyal friend, just smiled.
Let's have a party. I want to ring my new bells.
You stop that! You're making me dizzy!
Well, you are a cuckoo, aren't you?
Whee-hee!
I'd be happy to sing a few Christmas carols.
No, I think I should tell one of my stories.
No.
Ho ho! Tangy should tell a story. Right, Tangy? Tangy?
What's wrong, Tangy?
What is it, Tang? What are you thinking?
I was just thinking how nice it is to be home with my wonderful family on a cold night like this.
Virgil, Jack, and Bird thought about what Tangy had said, and they were all silent as they watched the snow falling, listening to the wind rattle the big glass window. And so the Tangerine Bear finally came to the end of his long journey to find a home. What he had learned is that if you look close enough, sometimes the things you want are right in front of your nose. That being different can make you special. And that happiness has no particular address.